check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys.
Hey, how's it going? This is DT here with another video for you. Question: do you desire backup power for your home, or a lot more control over your own power usage and not to have to be at the mercy of power companies? Well, how about a Tesla Powerwall? Who, me? Nah, I don't work for them, but I am a proud owner of one, and I want to go over some things you might not have known about the Powerwall too. Now, I own one in Japan, so we will be going over prices and processes here in Japan. So first off, you do not need to own a Tesla car to own one of these. It is its own product. You do not need to own solar panels to own this product, at least not in Japan anyway. Tesla has stated that in the States, the Powerwall will be sold as a set with its solar panels. In Japan, that hasn't started yet, and you can't even get Tesla solar panels in Japan anyway, at the time of this recording anyway. Solar panels will go nicely though with your setup, and we will talk about why in a minute. So the total system consists of a Powerwall 2 and a backup gateway. You cannot own one without the other. The backup gateway is the brain and the Powerwall 2 is the brawn. Also, the gateway acts as an inverter, converting DC to AC. And if you own a solar panel system, it will link to your solar inverter, which does the same thing. This power wall weighs around 400 pounds, so in Japan you cannot wall mount it on the side of your house. I asked already. It'll rip your wall off, especially if an earthquake occurs. But if you are in another country and you have a garage with cement walls and such, then you would be fine. And this unit is usually placed within about 20 feet of your meter. That's why mine is here. Both the Gateway 2 and the Powerwall 2 can be placed outside. In Japan, most houses don't have garages, but no need to worry. They can withstand extreme hot and cold ranges and have a waterproof rating of IP67, pretty high. And it comes with a 10-year warranty. I have seen it put out over 5 kilowatts of power when I charge my cars, and it still powers the entire house on its own. It is a beast. Now, with full installation, materials, everything is going to cost around 170,000, around $16,000 US, with the yen rate being what it is. You'll have guys say, oh man, I'm just going to link up some car batteries. Well, I'm not doing that. How would I be able to connect to it and do what I want with it? Also, this is aesthetically pleasing to the eye and waterproof. With the current firmware, it will pull from the grid if necessary, if it detects an incoming typhoon. I can have it in backup only mode, set a threshold for reserves, and still use it to power my house, or use time-based activation, which allows you to configure when to use it based on peak hours set by your power company, in my case, TEPCO. Oh, and by the way, none of this gets approved for construction without TEPCO's okay. So first off, you have to apply for one on Tesla Japan's website. They will converse with you via email. You can use Google Translate if you like to, but eventually you will be given paperwork fully in Japanese. It is basically a mini questionnaire asking if you have solar panels, your name, addresses, and other things. Easier to have your wife or husband, your Japanese national friend, fill it out if you cannot read it. Then you will send that back and they will come do a survey. Then you will get an invoice to e-sign. Then you will wire the money and they will set up an installation date. And you cannot buy this on your own and you cannot install it on your own. They will contract it out to someone and your costs will be included in that. Now, installation takes about 8 hours. Yeah, so plan accordingly, with a few 30-minute periods where your power will be cut off, so prepare for that. If you want one of these, get solar panels first, then the battery, so that, one, you're not relying 100% on TEPCO to fill up your battery and paying for that, and two, you are using reserve solar energy that your house didn't use, and three, you can essentially charge your cars up for free if you get your battery filled all the way up and power and charge when the sun is out like we do. So I highly recommend one, especially if you live in an area with outages and flooding. If you do live in an area with flooding, the company installing it will most likely know that already and have a workaround for you. You can even get crafty after you're done and get an enclosure built for it, like we are going to protect against typhoon, debris, etc. And finally, after you have completed construction, you have to register this product on your own so that you can control it via the app, along with any other Tesla devices you may have. To do this, you will need your gateway serial number and your gateway part number, which comes on a sticker on your user manual. Yeah, I had to figure that one out on my own. You're going to do all that via Tesla Japan's website. So that's the Powerwall 2 for you in Japan. I hope that helps answer some of your questions. Like and subscribe for more survival tips. This is DT. It's been a pleasure. See you on the next one. DT out.